Hi everyone, welcome to lesson 58, A Blessing in Disguise. 今天呢，我们一起学习第58课，课文的标题是 A Blessing in Disguise, 是因祸得福吗？ Well, the story is about a tree with an evil reputation. 课文讲的是一个有着恶名的这么一棵大树。那么，因祸得福和这棵树有什么关系呢？You'll soon learn about the story. Now, let's look at the keywords and expressions first. Blessing. Disguise. A blessing in disguise. Tiny. Friendly. Cursed. Evil reputation.Claim, victim, vicar, source of income, tree trunk. Okay, before you watch the flash, please look at the questions. 下面呢，我们先看看问题。Why has the number of visitors to the village of Friendly increased? 为什么到 Friendly 这个小村子来参观的人越来越多了？ Why does this tree have an evil reputation? 为什么这棵树有一个恶名呢？ Why has the vicar refused to have the tree cut down?教区牧师为什么拒绝让人把这棵树砍下来？ What has ever happened to the tourists who have been picking leaves and cutting their names on a tree trunk?
那些照常摘树叶把名字刻在树干上的那些游客得到了什么报应呢？
The tiny village of Friendly is said to possess a cursed tree.Because the tree was mentioned in a newspaper, the number of visitors to Friendly has now increased. The tree was planted near the church 50 years ago, but it is only in recent years that it has gained an evil reputation. It is said that if anyone touches the tree, he will have bad luck. If he picks a leaf, he will die.Many villagers believe that the tree has already claimed a number of victims. The vicar has been asked to have the tree cut down, but so far he has refused. He has pointed out that the tree is a useful source of income, as tourists have been coming from all parts of the country to see it. In spite of all that has been said, the tourists have been picking leavesand cutting their names on the tree trunk. So far, not one of them has been struck down by sudden death.
All right, now let's try to recall some of the details by trying to answer those questions. Why has the number of visitors to the village of Friendly increased?
为什么近年来到Friendly 这个村子来参观的人越来越多了。
Because the newspaper mentioned that there was a cursed tree in the village.
因为报纸上提到，在这个村子里呢，有一棵遭了咒的树。遭了咒的树
，cursed tree. Why does this tree have an evil reputation?
为什么这棵树有一个恶名呢？
Because it is said that if anyone touches the tree, he will have bad luck. If he picks a leaf, he will die.
因为据说，只要有人摸了这棵树，他就会交上厄运。要是他摘了一片树叶呢，他就会死去。
Why has the vicar refused to have the tree cut down?
教区牧师为什么拒绝让人把这棵树砍下来？
because he thinks that a tree is a useful source of income, as tourists have been coming from all parts of the country to see it.
因为他认为这棵树呢是一个有用的财源，因为全国各地都有游客到这个村子里来看这棵树。
What has ever happened to the tourists who have been picking leaves and cutting their names on a tree trunk?
那些摘树叶把名字刻在树干上的游客得到了什么样的报应呢？
Well, actually, nothing bad has ever happened to those tourists.
实际上呢，并没有什么厄运降临到这些游客头上。
So far, not one of them has been struck down by sudden death.
到目前为止，他们中还没有人暴死。
Right, that's all for the questions and answers. Let's look at the language points together. The tiny village of Frinley is said to possess a cursed tree.
据说Frinley 这个小村子里有一棵遭了咒的树。句中的 of 是一个介词，它呢表示同位关系。我们来看两个例子。
The city of New York，
纽约市。
The name of James，
詹姆士这个名字。
Is said 是被动语态的用法。Because the tree was mentioned in the newspaper, the number of visitors to Frinley has now increased.
就是因为报纸上提到了这棵树，所以呢，现在来 Frinley 参观的人越来越多了。这里的主语呢，是 the number, 而不是 visitors, 所以在谓语动词中也要保持单数形式
has increased。
另外请大家要注意介词 to 的用法，
visitors to Frinley，
这里的 to 表示到什么什么地方。
Many villagers believe that the tree has already claimed a number of victims。
许多村民都相信这棵树已经害了不少人。在这句话里边，我们要注意动词 claim 的用法，这是一个比较难用的词。在这里的意思呢，它是
cause the loss or death of somebody，
意思是因为灾难或者事故使某人失踪或者死亡。请看例句。
The earthquakeclaimed thousands of lives.
地震夺取了数以千计人的生命。
Claim
还可以有另外一个意思，它表示要求或者是索要什么东西。我们来看例句。
After the Duke's death, his eldest son claimed the title.
公爵死了以后呢，他的长子要求继承爵位，这里的 claim 就是要求什么。
She claims ownership of the land.
他对这块土地的产权提出要求。
The vicar has been asked to have the tree cut down.
人们曾经请求教区的牧师叫人把树砍掉。
Has been asked.
是被动语态。
Have the tree cut down，
意思是叫别人把树砍掉，也就是这样一个结构。
Have something done，
叫别人做某事。
She is going to have the house painted，
她打算叫人把屋子给粉刷一遍。这里
have the house painted
是叫别人把屋子来粉刷。Painted 是过去分词。
I'd like to have these flowers sent to room 202.
我想把这些花送到202房间，但是送花的人呢，一定是别人，而不是他自己。
In spite of all that has been said, the tourists have been picking leaves and cutting their names on the tree trunk.
尽管有上述的种种说法，但游客们还是照常摘树叶，把他们的名字刻在树干上。
In spite of 是介词短语，后面只能跟名词或者名词性从句，
这里呢跟的是代词 all 后面又跟了一个 that 引导的定语从句。 that 在这个定语从句中起的是主语的作用，所以呢不能像做宾语时那样省略。
另外在 all 后面跟定语从句时，关系代词只能用 that而不能用 which。
下面我们来看看两个例子。
I've done all that has to be done.
我做了该做的一切。这里 all 后面跟 that 引导的定语从句，在从句中 that 做主语，所以不省略。
All I know is that he is an honest person.
我所知道的就是他是一个诚实的人。在这里呢 that 可以省略，因为它是定语从句中做宾语，也可以不省略。
So far, not one of them has been struck down by sudden death.
到目前为止还没有一个人暴死。请大家注意 So far 一般都要跟现在完成时连用。
Strike down 意思是击倒或者使人死去。
请看例句。
He was struck down by a bus in the middle of the street.
他在街中央被一辆公共汽车撞倒了。
He was struck down by pneumonia while in his 20s.
他在20多岁的时候就被肺炎夺去了生命。在下面的关键句型部分，我们先要讲讲被动语态，然后让大家看一下强调句的用法。
The tiny village of Frindley is said to possess a cursed tree.
这个句子中 is said 是被动语态。这个句子呢也可以换成这样的说法。
It is said that the tiny village of Frindley possesses a cursed tree.
下面我们再看几个被动语态的句子。
The vicar has been asked to have the tree cut down, but so far he has refused.
这里的被动语态呢是 has been asked.
The boy was told to be quiet.
有人让这个男孩子安静点。被动语态 was told.
She was reminded not to leave valuable things in the room.
她被提醒不要把贵重物品留在屋子里。被动语态 was reminded. 在这几个例句中，我们看出动词 ask, tell, remind 变成被动语态，后面再加不定式的这么一种结构，请大家注意一下。好，下面我们再看看强调句。
It is only in recent years that it has gained an evil reputation.
只是在近几年，这棵树呢才得到了一个坏名声。这里呢强调的是 in recent years, 时间状语。
It was in England that we first met.
我们最早是在英国见面的。这里强调的是一个地点状语 in England.
It's he who has solved the problem for you.
是他替你解决了这个问题。这里强调的是主语 he.
It was because of him that we succeeded.
正是因为他我们才成功了。 这里呢强调的是一个原因状语 because of him。 通过以上例句，我们可以看出强调句的构成呢是由 it is 或者 it was 加上 that 这样一个结构构成的。好，关键句型我们就看到这儿。回到课文的内容上来呢，我们可以看出关于课文中的 cursed tree 的种种说法其实不过是个迷信。迷信这个单词在英文中是 superstition。 其实呢，村子里的人也没有把这个诅咒呢太当回事， They don't take it seriously really。 不过教区的牧师倒是一个非常聪明的人， A smart man， 因为他在这棵树上看到了有用的旅游资源， A useful source of income。 因祸得福是英文中一个很有用的表达式。如果你遇到一种情形看似是坏事实际上是好事呢，你就可以说 That's a blessing in disguise。 OK, that's it for today. See you next time.